In this tutorial, we will try to analyze the requirement that we have considered for building this particular Stateflow model, and we'll try to verify whether it is working fine or not. We will be using step buttons, which are mentioned on the top beside the play button, and will run this particular Stateflow model based on different sample time. So let's analyze the model now that we have developed. As you can see over here on the downside, t equal to 0.000, which is the starting time of the simulation, which is the first sample time. As we have defined, the switch should be on by giving it a constant value of 1, and d is less than the required distance, then in that case the cruise control should turn on. So now let's see what is actually there in the initial sample time. As we have already seen, we have a default transition that is there in this state flow diagram. Due to that reason, the system wakes up and it got initialized at the default one, where in this case the default one is the op state. Now if I step again based on the conditions that I have over here, switch is on for this cruise control and the distance is less than 2 meters, which is now 1 meter, the cruise control will turn on in the next sample time. So let's see how it works. Whenever you see something is blue, that particular state is active. In this case, the op state is active. Now let's step and see how the system behaves based on the inputs that we have given. Now we are at the first sample time, which is 0.2. As we can see over here, the on state got activated. Along with that, whatever the condition that we have given, by default acceleration is the default condition, so that's why this particular state got activated when the on state got activated. Now when I go to the next sample time, based on the distance that I have given, which is 1 meter, any one of the condition will satisfy and it will do the required operation. So if I step again, the system went into the braking stage, or the cruise control will brake now. Why it will brake? Because the distance between our vehicle and the front vehicle got reduced than the required distance that we want. Now we will be braking and the distance between the two vehicles will increase. As we don't have the plant model now with us, and we have only the state flow model, so we can change this particular distance by manipulating the constant value. So now if I change my constant value to 4 meter and press on OK, and again I will step again, as now here the required distance is less than the actual distance, then in this case we will be accelerating so that the distance between the two vehicle will reduce. If I step now, it became, if I step now, then it will come to the acceleration stage. So this is how the state flow model will be working for a cruise control system, and we have built it based on the requirement document that we have. First, the default stage will turn on in the initial sample time. We have observed in this particular tutorial that the default transition will activate when the system gets turns on, which is at the initial sample time. And in the next sample time, if the conditions are satisfying for taking the transition, then the transition will happen to the other state. If it is not satisfied, then it will stay in the same stage. So this is how a cruise control system will try to maintain the distance between the two vehicles, based on acceleration and braking to maintain the constant distance d over time. In case you are liking the channel, please consider subscribing. We will be bringing up more innovative content into the channel so that you can improve your knowledge based on MATLAB as well as Stateflow on Simulink. So happy learning, MATLAB.